Hi everyone and welcome to my another video on JavaScript interviews. And in this video we are going to talk about important aspect which is closure in JavaScript, and you can say closure with set timeout, or you can say a synchronous loop with asynchronous code inside it. Okay, so first we will try to understand what is closure, and then we will relate what is the closure, how we are using closure in this example, and how we are using this asynchronous operation which is set timeout. Okay, so first we will talk about definition of closure. A closure is an inner function that has access to the outer function variables. In other words, a function defined and invoked inside another function is called closure. Crystal and crisp definition is this: the closure has a different scope, it has access to all different scope, everything which is defined inside these brackets, or everything which is defined, because this closure has access to the immediate outer scope and the global scope. Okay, it has access to the outer functions variable and it has access to the global variables also. Okay, so how why this example looks like a closure? You can say that set timeout is actually creating a closure function inside it. So here, if we talk about the output of this particular code, here we have a synchronous loop and we are doing set timeout, and here we are getting 404, 4 times, and output of array of I is undefined because I become 4 and there is no index 4 in this particular array. So if we talk about the explanation of this output of set timeout function create a function, the closure, that has access to its outer scope. So this is an inner function defined inside a function. Okay, so this has access, this actually acts like a closure which has access to its outer scope, which is the loop that contains the index I. Okay, this is the loop which contains the I, and after 1 second we have a timeout, right? After 1 second, because this is a synchronous loop and set timeout will wait for 1 second, and meanwhile this has already been executed and I will become 4 meanwhile. Okay, so in that case what will happen is, in this cycle I is going through 0 1 2 3 4, and loop finally stops at 4, and array of 4 doesn't exist in this particular array, so which is why you get undefined. Okay, so how we are accessing the value I, and how this value become 4? So the variable I is actually declared within the for loop and the inner function accesses it. Yes, this is the for loop and I have access to this value I. So when the for loop is done running, each of the inner function refers to the same variable I, which at the end of the loop equals to the 3. Okay, that is correct. I will become 3, and then we have I plus plus, so it will become 4 for this particular execution, right? And we have the same variable in the outer loop and same variable we are accessing inside a inner loop for every iteration. So even if I become 3, it will access the value of I after 1 second, that will become 4 after increment. So our goal is for each inner function to maintain its reference to the variable I without the value being altered. Okay, what is happening is we are accessing the same value I, and that is being altered from 0 to 1 2 3, and we are having access to the value 3 after increment, that is becoming 4, and we are able to access only 4. Okay, so how we can actually fix this problem? Currently this is like a for loop, set timeout not working, we are getting undefined and able to print only the last value. In this case here it is becoming undefined because the value index is becoming 4, which is not there with the array. Okay, so we'll talk about all different solutions how we can fix this. The only problem we see is this become closure and it is having access to the same variable over the time, which is getting altered. Okay, we can wrap this set timeout somehow so that every iteration of the for loop maintains its own scope. Set timeout maintain the same value of I for each, different value of I for each and every iteration. Okay, so how can we fix this? There are different ways of fixing it. We will solve this problem using immediate invoke functional expression. That is the one way. We just wrap this into if block, or you can actually convert this into the let. So what will happen is, for every iteration, if we use let instead of I var keyword, let I 0, I is less than array dot length. So if we are using I let keyword, it has a block level scope, and this will fix the problem. For each and every block, inner block, the different values of I will be assigned. Another fix what we can do is pass the value of I in the set timeout. So what we are doing is we have the array, pass the value of I so that each iteration has the access, has the value, has the access to the correct index. Here this is a set timeout, and we wrap it inside a ify block, you can say set timeout and ify block. So the values inside this set timeout will maintain their own values. You can say this is a ify block, ify expression, and we are passing the value of I, and set timeout, it is executing after that seconds. It's we are incrementing, right? So we just wrap it, either you wrap the ify block outside the set timeout. Here we did a reverse, we are putting a ify block inside the set timeout, and for each and every value of I will be maintained inside this ify block. That is a fix. Second fix, like either you use a let keyword or use a ify block inside a set timeout, or there may be a possibly solution 3, use different iterators like variable I and j, which use different iterator. So if you talk about this example has the same problem, right? We are not creating the scope for each and every iteration using ify block. So if you try to fix it using ify block outside this, this we will close it, and then we are passing I, which is I local, let's call it as I, and we are able to print it. So what we did is we just introduced this ify block, and we wrap the set timeout inside it. This will also fix our problem. So if we just try to execute this, I 1, 2, 3, you can see the output which is coming. So that is fixing our problem, right? Now another way to fix it is you can actually have another reference of variable. Like this, I'll just try to run this and try to show you. So here we are creating a reference, another reference, J, which is getting created every time in each and every iteration, and J will maintain its value. So I was 1, J is 1. I was 2, J will be 2 for another reference. So here we created a let, which has a block level scope. Okay. So this is another fix. Here you will get the value I 1, 2, 3, and everything is fine. It preserves separate values of J for each and every iteration. It runs every time as the loop iterate, and J is created for each and every iteration, which is not altered because next value of J will be different for the next iteration. And here we are passing J. It just puts that timeout, but this is what creating the new reference. Okay, so different examples to understand the closer and executing the set timeout asynchronous operations inside a loop. Okay, that's it guys. Thanks everyone.